prepared to talk about that. Christy asked me to talk about some of my favorite trees, or my favorite tree. But one of the difficulties of managing a property like this is we're nonprofit, and so money's pretty short, and trees are getting more and more expensive to take care of. And we do the best we can, trying to find the lowest price contractors, but and try to do as much as we can ourselves. And one of my favorite trees, I couldn't narrow it down to one. There are several, but the first one I'm going to talk about is a London Plane that's behind the Hayes home, and it's, I don't know exactly how it is, but I can see it right out of my dining room window, the bay window, and I can see it, especially in the mornings, when the sun's just hitting the top of it. It just looks like the top part of the tree is just glowing, and it's just a gorgeous, gorgeous tree, and I just appreciate that. And there's a tree right beside it called a tricolor beech. And my former boss, it was his favorite tree. Now the one that's back there is not the one he planted, it's a replacement. And just a short distance from there, the last tree I want to talk about, it isn't here anymore. It died a few years ago. It was the Admiral Nimitz oak tree. Magnificent, huge oak tree. And Admiral Nimitz was here, actually touched the tree, and that's how I got named after him, as Christy already explained. And it died a few years ago. I've been here about 43 years. And over those years, I've seen elderly gentlemen who served in World War II and served under them come here and gather under that tree, and you can just watch these men hugging each other and weeping as they remember the awful, awful things they had to go through. And it was, of course, that generation. Actually, in part of Rudd's diary, he talks about his neighbors, that they invited him to come to the grove. Rudd and Lucy understood that this place is special, that there's just something here that brings peace to people. And they invited their neighbors to come, and so we've continued that, and we allow the public. And even part of our long-range plan talks about us advertising and talking about the grounds as a place of healing. A place where you can come, forget about the craziness of this world. We all know 2020's gone, but so far 2021 hasn't been much of an improvement. But anyway, people come, they walk here, they enjoy the grounds, and they're touched by the peace. I don't understand. It just seems to invade this place. And if you haven't been here, you need to come and enjoy the ground. So, thank you.
I'm John Havens. I serve on the Building and Grounds Committee. And I would like to talk about the tree that we're going to be planting today. You know, as I walk through the grounds, and we've worked a lot on a tree tour, and we welcome you to come and see our tree tour and participate in it. A few trees that stick out in my mind, the American hornbeam on the property is probably one of the largest in the state. We have the great big ginkgo in the back. Ginkgos were thought to be extinct until about the 1600s, where they were rediscovered again. Magnificent one here. And then, of course, the big white oaks, the bicentennial oak, standing here during the American Revolution. This is amazing to see. And when you talk about old trees, you can always look to the bristlecone pines. Bristlecone pines are the oldest living thing on the earth. They can live up to 4,000 years. The one that we're going to plant today is a Rocky Mountain bristlecone pine, a Pinus aristatus. And we're going to be putting that in today. Kind of a unique tree. It's just a little guy right now. Hopefully in about 20 years, it reaches about 4 foot in height by that time. It should mature out somewhere close to 20 foot in height. It'll gather in width as it gets a little bit older, about 1 inch every 100 years. So it's a very, very slow grower. If you come out and look at it, you're going to go, wow, it's got scale or something on it, or is that dandruff on it? It's really not. This variety of bristlecone pine just has a single canal for the material, so right up through the needles on, and as they break, a little bit leaks out, and it forms like a dandruff on the tree. It's the only pine that does it. It's kind of unusual. Neat tree. Thanks for coming out. Happy Arbor Day.
You're right. The scissors don't equal the magnitude of the bow.